Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about optical transducer trainer and its order code is BM2720. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. So this is the optical transducer trainer. So here we are having pin photodiode, photoconductive cell, lamp filament, phototransistor, photovoltaic cell. All these are located inside this white box. Then this is the buzzer, this is the LED, this is the relay, this is the supply section, that is plus 12 volt, plus 5 volt, and this is the ground port. Then this is the moving coil meter, then this is the buffer, this is the current amplifier, this is the electronic switch, then this is the comparator, this is power amplifier, this is potentiometer of 10K and this is another potentiometer of 10K. Then this is slide potentiometer of 10K. Then this is the power supply section, this is the main power on off switch and this is the fuse. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study the characteristics of filament lamp. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the socket C of potentiometer 10K will be connected to the plus 12 volt supply and we will connect the socket A with the 0 volt port like this. And now we will connect the B port of the potentiometer to the power amplifier input port and now we will connect the output of power amplifier to input of filament lamp through a digital multimeter. So we will connect a multimeter at milliampere range and we will connect it across power amplifier and lamp filament port like this. And now we will connect the other port of lamp filament to the positive of moving coil meter and now we will connect the negative of moving coil meter to the 0 volt like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit, but first we have to keep this 10K pot at fully clockwise position so that the resistance value is minimum. Now we will slowly increase the resistance value. So now when we rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, so here on the moving coil meter you can see that the voltage increases because at first we have kept this potentiometer pot at fully clockwise position so that the voltage is zero and now we have to give some voltage. So we have to rotate it in anti-clockwise direction and here we can see that the moving coil meter is showing some voltage value. Let's set it at 2 volt and now read the milliampere current at the multimeter pot. So here on the multimeter you can get the milliampere current and here on the moving coil meter you can get the voltage value. So that is how you can take different readings at different voltages and you can see the lamp glowing. So that is how you can form the table and plot the graph between voltage and milliampere. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study characteristics of photovoltaic cell. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the C port of potentiometer 10K to the plus 12 volt and now we will connect the A port of the potentiometer to the 0 volt port like this and now we will connect the B port to the power amplifier input port like this and now we will connect the output of power amplifier port to the input of lamp filament and the other port of lamp filament is connected to the positive of moving coil meter, and now we will connect the negative and zero volt of moving coil meter like this. And now we will connect a multimeter across photovoltaic cell and 0 volt like this. So we have connected a multimeter at milliampere range, and we have connected it across photovoltaic cell output port, and the other is connected to the 0 volt like this. So that is how the connection is done. And now we will switch on the kit, but first we have to keep this potentiometer port at fully clockwise position so that the voltage reading is 0 here. Now we will switch on the kit and we will vary this potentiometer port in anti-clockwise direction. So let's keep it at voltage 2 volt. So when we rotate this potentiometer port in anti-clockwise direction, this voltage reading changes. So let's keep it at 2 volt, and here on the multimeter you can see the milliampere current value, that is 0.7 milliampere, and you can see the lamp filament glowing. So that is how you can take the readings of this voltmeter and this milliampere readings. And now we will measure the open circuit output voltage. So for that we will first switch off the kit, and we will keep this potentiometer pot again at minimum position so that the voltage reading is 0. And now we will connect this multimeter at voltage mode and now we will connect it across this photovoltaic cell like this. And now we will switch on the kit, and now we will measure the open circuit output voltage. So here when we vary this potentiometer pot, we can get the open circuit output voltage, that is 1.4 volt. So that is how you can take different readings and form the table and plot the graph. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study characteristics of photoconductive cell. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the port C of potentiometer to the plus 12 volt port like this. And now we will connect the A port to the 0 volt port like this. And now we will connect the B port to the power amplifier input port like this. And now we will connect the output port of the power amplifier to the lamp filament input like this. And now we will connect the other input of lamp filament to the positive of moving coil meter. And now we will connect the negative and zero of moving coil meter like this. Now we will connect the C port of slide potentiometer to plus 5 volt like this. And now we will connect the B port of slide potentiometer to output of photoconductive cell like this. And now we will connect a multimeter across photoconductive cell at voltage range like this. And now we will connect it across the photoconductive cell. So the positive will be connected to the photoconductive cell and the negative will be connected to 0 volt like this. And now we have to set this slide potentiometer at So for that we will use another multimeter and we will set it at 3K. So here you can see that when you slide this potentiometer, you can change the resistance value. So we have to keep it at 3K. So we will slide it and we will keep it at 3 kilo ohm like this. Now after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit, but first we have to keep this potentiometer position at fully clockwise position so that the voltmeter gives zero reading. And now we will switch on the kit. So after switching on the kit, now we will vary this potentiometer pot in anti-clockwise direction, and now we will keep it at 2 volt. So here on this voltmeter you can see the voltage, so it is at 2 volt. So here on the multimeter you can see the voltage reading. So on multimeter we are getting the photoconductive cell output voltage, and here we are getting the lamp filament voltage. So you can take different readings by varying this potentiometer pot, and you can see the lamp glowing here. So you can get different readings, and you can form the table and you can plot the graph between photoconductive cell output voltage and the lamp filament voltage. So that is how you can perform this experiment. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.